Hi guys, this is Max from HighOnAndroid.com, where we get
hot on Android every day.
Anyway, today we're going to go ahead and take a look at stuff you must do after buying the Galaxy S9 or S9 Plus. If you're new to Samsung Galaxy stuff, this video should help you save a ton of power and battery life and who knows what. Let's go ahead and take a look. Okay guys, if you want to take full advantage of the 1440p screen on the Galaxy S9 or S9 Plus, did you know that it does not default to 1440p? So if you want to enjoy 1440p videos on YouTube, or maybe you have 4K videos on your phone that you want to watch, if you watch it normally, you will only get 1080p, it will be downscaled. If you set it to 1440p, you'll be able to enjoy 4K, at least in 1440p. You can find that in settings display, all right, and you can go ahead and set this to 2960 by 1440. Now there's a better way since 1440p does give you more battery loss, maybe 5 to 10% more on average. So a better way to do that, to set your performance mode. So go ahead and do a long press on your performance mode. And I do recommend the entertainment mode, which I like the most. And this defaults to 10% increased brightness, screen resolution to WQHD Plus, which is the 1440p. Also gives you video enhancer, also UHQ upscaler for your music. All right, go ahead and hit apply. And your phone's now running in 1440p, and also it is 10% brighter than normal. So if you're not outdoors, if you're home, if you're next to a charger, you're charging your phone, then you can go ahead and toggle this. All right, and when you're traveling, you need more battery life, you can toggle that off and instantly you're back to normal mode. Once you set it, you can always go ahead and set back to entertainment mode. All right, there's also other modes that you can set to. If you're a gamer, for example, you can also launch Game Launcher, which allows to record your games easily. All right, you can also set this to WQHD, increase brightness, apply. So make sure you set up your performance mode, that way you can get most out of it. A lot of people use their whole phone in default mode and they don't even know that you can actually set your phone to 1440p. Alright, as far as the screen goes, you can also, if you go into settings, display, you can go ahead and change the screen mode. Alright, depending on what you like. Adaptive mode is the most basic one that will basically change the colors based on your environment. If you watch a lot of movies, AMOLED cinema mode sort of gives you warmer colors. If you're a photographer, AMOLED photo may give you more truer colors. Also adaptive display, you can also customize your screen if you want to make it cooler, warmer. And also you can even add more green.
Add less blue, add more blue, add less red, add more red.
I actually prefer the AMOLED photo mode, all right? All right, let's talk about power saving mode. Now, what I've shown you was how to increase the performance. What if you run out of battery life? A lot of people don't know there's one of the best power saving mode on the Galaxy S9 and S9 Plus or any of the Galaxy phones. Go ahead and do a long press on power saving mode, all right? And this will give you a couple different settings that you can set, all right? For example, medium
Will give you decreased brightness. You can set the screen resolution to much lower, even HD Plus if you want. Also will limit your CPU speed, so you'll save battery life. You can turn off always on display.
If we go ahead and apply this, this will show you estimate time remaining. So even though I have 45%, now I can go 8 hours. This is pretty much a slowdown mode for your phone. Another way to save even more battery life, let's say you went out one night with your friends and you only had maybe 10% battery life. Then you can go into max mode, all right, which does even more stuff. If you apply this, you'll get all the basic apps you need, all right? So from 7 hours, once I apply this, I can go almost twice longer on 45% battery life. I can go almost a whole day, all right? If you have like 10% battery life, you can still go like 10 hours using this mode. Of course, you only get basic apps that you choose, but this is the ultimate power saving mode that Samsung invented, and now you know how to use this. And anytime you want to turn it off, you can go ahead and turn off maximum power saving mode, and boom shakalaka, you're back to normal. Now, in general, AMOLED screens, if you have black background, it uses zero energy versus LCD. So another way to save battery all the time is go ahead and find a theme, Samsung Theme Store. There's a bunch of free ones. Here's a really dark theme. And if you use dark theme, you will, on average, can save up to like anywhere between like 3 to 8%, just because your phone is not using any energy for the black background. All right, this will make it all very black. And also, with a good black theme, everything becomes black. So all of this stuff that was using battery life, especially when we're going settings, everything's black background, so you'll save a ton of battery life. This is probably the number one thing you should do if you want to save battery life: black background. Obviously, more battery life for you. All right. Another thing, you never know. You might meet a celebrity in real life, especially doing selfies. And did you know you can use the volume keys as shutter? So by default, you can actually use the volume keys as shutter. Right, this works great. Let's say you want to take selfies with a celebrity that you met on the street. All right, now you can go ahead and take selfies with the back camera easily using the volume keys. Of course, another very useful setting that I always turn on is voice control. You'll be able to take pictures by saying smile cheese or even use capture shoot to record videos. I find this very, very useful, especially when taking selfies. You can just be like cheese. And boom shakalaka, takes a photo for you. Not a huge thing, but I really like it. Another tip, if you make a lot of GIFs or GIFs, whatever you want to call it, another way I like to do it is change the whole camera button. Usually it'll take burst shot. You could go ahead and change this to create GIF. So anytime you want to create GIF, now you can just simply go ahead and hold down the camera button. And quickly, I can create a cool GIF like this. All right, if you're using super slow-mo, and sometimes the automatic thing doesn't pop unless you actually center it. Let's say you want your subject below that, then you can go ahead and set this to manual. And this way, you can go ahead and anytime just press this button and it will do a slow motion regardless of that screen. All right, and this way, all right, you could do a slow motion when you want to. Another tip, Samsung starts adding this music you might not enjoy too much. You want the original. Just go into the music tab and use the video sound.
You can go ahead and anytime just...
All right, that way you get the original sound, original super slow motion of whatever you shot. All right, I know a lot of you probably use screenshot. Probably the simplest way, obviously, is to do volume down and the power. All right, anytime you want to draw, go ahead and click on the draw button right after you take a screenshot, and you can go ahead and draw whatever you want. Obviously, you can go ahead and change the pen. All right, when you're done, you can go ahead and crop it to your liking, save, share, whatever you want to do. Another way you could do it, using the rectangle or oval, anytime you want to take like a section of a website or something, then you can do that. Done. Same thing, you could draw, save, share. Same thing with oval. If you want to make a quick GIF of your favorite YouTuber, you can go ahead and go hit that button, move this up, record, stop, and you can make a quick GIF out of it and go ahead and save, all right? Which is a very nice feature. All right, a lot of times maybe you're copying and pasting something and you wanna keep it on the screen. Let's say you see something interesting, you wanna keep looking at it, maybe copy and pasting, or maybe you're copying and pasting a credit card number, or I don't know, whatever it is. Then you can go ahead and set this in a floating mode, all right? This way, whatever app you go next, it will stay on there and you can go ahead and copy and paste it. And you can go ahead and resize it if you want. All right, another way to do it is you could use a pin to screen. You can literally just find any kind of information. Let's say Rob sent me this and I want to be able to copy and paste it somewhere using Word Docs. I can go ahead and pin that, and no matter where I go, it will stay on there. And when I'm done with it, I can simply go ahead and X to exit out. All right, could be very useful in a lot of situations. Next, if you want to change the button layouts, this is actually the opposite of the way it should be. Go into settings, display, go to navigation bar, and you can go ahead and change your button layout to back home recents or recent home back, like that. But I prefer back home recents, all right? That's how I like it. All right, to some people like myself, probably the most annoying button, the Bixby button. All right, how do you get rid of it? It is really simple. Just go ahead and swipe left to the Bixby home, make sure you're signed in, and you're gonna go into settings here and turn off the Bixby key. All right, your Bixby key will still work. They'll just not activate if you accidentally press it, which is very nice. And if you want to use Bixby, just hold it down. Hey Bixby, what's the weather today? All right, and just let go.
Clouds throughout the day.
All right, I think that's a better option, so you could go ahead and long hold the Bixby key. Now, there's several apps on the Play Store. You could also customize it. All right, also, if you tend to use your phone at night often, I do highly recommend using the blue light filter. You can go ahead and find this in your quick settings here. Go ahead and do a long press and turn on as scheduled. Turn that on and set it to sunset to sunrise. This will help you use your phone more often at night without affecting your sleep. Scientifically, this is supposed to help. So definitely I recommend leaving it on for those who use your phone before going to sleep. All right, probably one of the coolest features of the Galaxy S9, you can set any videos as your lock screen wallpaper or even wallpaper. All right, for example, let me go ahead and set this as my wallpaper. Go to set as wallpaper. All right, you might have to edit it out to 15 seconds. Set as wallpaper. And
boom shakalaka.
All right, every time I open my phone, I can see a video of my daughter swinging a golf club. How cool is that? All right, there's even a way to add your favorite GIF as always on display. I do have a video on that. I'll put that in the... And you can see my S8 also doing it. I do have a full tutorial on that. Check that out too. I'll put that in the description. All right, guys, for those of you moving from iPhones, did you know that quick settings, you can go ahead and turn off your Wi-Fi, turn it on. All of your quick settings are up here. And you can edit this on the Galaxy S9, simply hitting that button and go to button order. For example, you use performance mode often a lot. You can go ahead and put that at the top. All right, maybe mobile hotspot often, go put that at the top. And while we're speaking of it, Dolby Atmos. If you did not enable this, definitely move this up here. All right, and turn it on and make sure it's on. And especially for those of you headphone users, the feature is there. Make sure you turn it on. By the way, that was a suggestion from Dan Dollywall. Thank you for the suggestion. He also said, if you have a tempered glass screen protector, you can turn the touch sensitivity up. All right, so Samsung has added additional feature for those of you using a tempered glass. You know how most tempered glass make your screen, your touch sensitivity go down. You can go ahead and type touch and you'll find menu called touch sensitivity. Go in there and you can go ahead and increase the touch sensitivity for screen using with screen protectors. All right, I should actually have a review of some tempered glass. Now this setting is available on the Galaxy S9 and S9 Plus. Now, for those of you new to Samsung Galaxy phones, if you're not using a fast wireless charger, you're totally missing out on the convenience, all right? This is Samsung's original fast charger, which was really well. It's not as fast as using quick charge, but I have this in my bedside table. I have it on my office table. Makes charging so much easier because you don't have to fiddle with cables and whatnot. All right, do highly recommend this. If you want to get a cheaper version of it, Ring K sells fast charge, which is 100% compatible with the Galaxy S9 and S9 Plus. It's going to give you just as fast wireless charging. All right, do highly recommend it. And of course, for those of you new to Android or Samsung phones, pretty much all Samsung phones support quick charge, all right? If you're still using a USB charger that does not support fast charging, it's time to get one. Make sure you grab a USB power bank that says quick charge 3.0. If you buy USB power banks at Best Buy, none of them actually support quick charge 3.0. This one does. I really love this. This is a Cray Plus. I do have a video on the most slim and portable power banks, and this thing saves you a ton of time. Very slim, you can put it in your pocket, simply charge it, you'll get fast charging right away. You know, you'll be able to charge from like 0 to 50% in matter of like 30 to 40 minutes, which is very nice if you're on the go. That way, when you're done, put this bad boy in your jacket, put this in your pocket, and boom, you don't have to worry about power. So definitely one of the first thing you should get is definitely a fast wireless charger and a quick charge USB power bank. All right, those are like essentials for all the Galaxies. All right, one last feature that's kind of cool, if you guys don't know about it, if you go into your gallery, your phone will literally create stories for you, all right? Sometimes it's very interesting. I got this hot diggity dog auto-created, and this is really cool way to share your photos really quickly. It even adds music, and it's so cool, right? It automatically finds your interesting photos and puts them together. And I felt like this one was actually pretty good. Featuring my dog, of course. All right, lastly but not least, I do highly recommend getting a case because the Galaxy phones that have curved edges, it is more prone to breaking because of the curved edges when you drop it, especially in concrete, you drop it on corners. Anytime you do that, it's literally gonna break 100% of the time. And I've actually broken more Galaxy phones than any other phone due to the curved screen. Unfortunately, it looks great, but it's not very practical. Especially you drop it. So I do highly recommend using a nice case. And my favorite current case is the Spigen Tough Armor. This is a very nice case that will protect your phone really well. It gives you a slight gap when you drop it, even on the corners. That way you have some insurance, all right, against cracking the face of your phone. And I really like this. It's got a kickstand, especially with the dual speakers on the S9 and S9 Plus. A lot of times I'll be watching Netflix or YouTube while eating dinner. And boom shakalaka. All right, really love this, highly recommend it. I'll have links in the description where you can get this also. And thank you guys for watching this video. Please hit the thumbs up if this video has helped you. And as always, stay
hard on Android.
Click here to subscribe.